work. But it looks so good that I just figured I'll keep it and try to fix it because it's the most reliable one apparently. The 60 gigabyte hard drive. Flaps work good. Still got the cover on it. Just good and bad. This one's screwed to it. Grab a Torx screwdriver. See why it doesn't work. Every single one of these green caps has exploded. Nice design. Well, it actually is a really nice design. I just put bad caps in it. Phillips Drive. I'm not sure if that's good or not. I could just clip this back in. Pretty clean. Compared to the other 360s I've seen. Take out all the other screws, so maybe these ones for now. I accidentally got the wrong kit. Hopefully, looks like it might. Yeah, these have the same values as these. They're the upgraded ones. Thankfully, I got that kit. Not sure about these ones. They're not exploded, so I might not even need to replace those. Maybe it's these ones. Yeah, those are them. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. Yeah, I'll put those two. Nice. Hopefully be able to fix this. Oh, tantalum caps. Looks like it's basically the same as a Falcon anyway. Thank you. Hopefully this will be a really nice console when I'm done. Doesn't look like the caps destroyed anything when they leaked. You probably want a special tool like this or something like this to take this apart properly. So this is actually a Xbox 360 tool. It's just what it's for. So I'm gonna undo all these motherboard screws here. Off that X clamp. Both X clamps. Use this forward off. Just put these to the side. Yeah, we're capping this and put some new thermal paste on.
That was literally the toughest thing I've ever recapped ever. A lot of these caps were in the high heat area and they just wouldn't even get molten, even if you hold the iron on it for like 10 seconds. You had to add solder to them like three times in a row, some of them. These ones are all completely exploded. They're like shells of what they used to be. These ones are probably still okay, but still pretty dried up. I just replaced everything because I had it all. Good thing the Falcon board was basically the same cap-wise. They had all the caps in it that I needed. Every single cap on the board, so I guess they just have a couple different chips or something. I don't know. It's like 50, 60 caps or something, I have no idea. It's just that they took forever to do. Mainly these black ones. The green ones were like five times easier to take off. And even soldering them back on was tough, like the solder wouldn't even flow to it. It's pads are so damaged from the heat, the whole thing just heats up so much. It's hotter than anything I've ever soldered, and I've soldered like 50 different things or something, I don't know. So the Xbox is cool, but really, really bad design. Hopefully this actually helps it. Makes it last like as much as a good design thing would. They're better capacitors, so hopefully it does. With these ones on here, I don't know, something got stuck in the middle of one of the ports, so I had to sort of surface mount these two. I was just messing around with it for like 30 minutes and I couldn't clear the holes. And these ones are pretty tough, but by that time I got a bit better at it, so I made them work. These harder ones were about five times easier than these ones because the solder wasn't as dried up and fluxless. Like these ones are just completely fucked. I'm just gonna install these things here. Paste there from cleaning off the board.
good, hopefully. Thank you. there. It's fully reassembled. Now to test it out. See if this was all worth it.